when she and 10 other Edina High School students sat during the playing of taps at a Veterans Day ceremony, junior Samira Calmoy says she knew exactly what she was doing.
Taps, national anthem, like regardless, I don't feel like I should be standing for that because I don't believe in it.
And why is that?
I don't believe in it because there's not freedom and justice for all.
That protest led to verbal and written clashes between students. And last week, a lawsuit filed by members of the Young Conservative Club who claimed the district shut down their group and violated their First Amendment rights. Days later, the two sides still starkly disagree.
So that was a problem with these students is they were attacking other students. And then they played that victim card so it didn't make it look as bad.
I think the easy way to get at this is to make it a racial thing, and it's not. And it's about respecting the rights of protesters and the rights to disagree with those protesters.
Jeff Spade says his son, the president of the YCC, has been harassed every day since the lawsuit was filed.
He gets threatened on social media, you know, threatened he's going to get jumped.
But Spades believes the problem at Edina High School goes beyond the TAPS protest and how the school handled it. He believes teachers focus on politics from liberal viewpoints in just about every class.
I'd like to think that if my son goes into a math class, he's being taught math, and that his politics nor the teacher's politics really matter.
Meantime, Calmoy, the president of the Edina Black Student Union, believes families with those frustrations aren't seeing the viewpoint of minority students.
They're blinded by their privilege. That's what I would say.
Lou Ragus, Care 11 News.
An Edina High School spokesperson says in a statement, the district respects the free speech rights of all students.